out! Tories out! Tories out! Tories out! Tories out!
Tories out! We're on Twitter. If you're on any sort of social media, go to the hashtag Windrush flight, which is leaving on Thursday, and stop the Windrush flight. It'll be up and it'll be on Twitter, and you basically say to the governor, Sajid Javid now, you basically demand that that flight does not go and return the UK passport holders.
Excellent, thank you very much. So next, we've got Jim
Curran. ...about the appalling discrimination that's been meted out to the Caribbean community and to other citizens of the Commonwealth. The Home Secretary has resigned, and she's resigned over a letter that she received and told lies about. Theresa May also got a copy of that letter, and she knew full well what was contained in that letter, and she also should resign. And we should call for her resignation.
She wasn't the origin of that policy. That policy was in the Home Office before Amber Rudd took over in the Home Office. So that policy is the policy of the person who was there before her. It's the policy of Theresa May. And Theresa May has questions to answer about this. That they then imposed on schools, and it was never an education policy at all, where they were asking schools to ask parents about the nationality of their children. They were trying to turn schools into mini immigration offices. And I tell you, we need our schools to be places of love. We need parents to be free, to feel free that they can come into a school and talk with a teacher and talk education, not deportation. Schools should never be immigration offices. Hospitals should never be immigration offices. And when they try and create a hostile environment, as they say, for illegal migrants, they're actually making a hostile environment for every person of colour in this country. And Theresa May has to stand responsible for trying to create that policy. And she now has questions to answer. And I want to say that it's not only the Windrush generation that should be allowed to stay. They should. They have been so badly treated, and they need compensation, I think, for what they've been put through. They need compensation for money they've paid out, but they need compensation for the insult to them. And they need compensation, they need apology from this government. But also the EU migrants need to be allowed to stay. And when you start saying you don't want migrants, you don't want illegal migrants, you don't want other migrants, everybody takes a message from it. And people from the EU are leaving leaving our National Health Service because they feel unwelcome as well. So we need to speak up for the Windrush generation and for the EU migrants.
And the Commonwealth.
And the whole of the Commonwealth. The whole of the Commonwealth, the whole of the EU, people should be allowed to stay. And I want to say...
So good afternoon, sisters and brothers. I hope you're all feeling good this afternoon, because you should be feeling good. Because what happened last night with the resignation of Amber Rudd is, as Kevin has just said, is precisely because here in London and up and down the country, people stood up, people were angry, and people protest, and people said, we are not going to stand for this disgrace, you must go.
It's not enough though, is it?
It's not enough. And I say this, I stand here myself as the proud son of parents who came to this country from the Caribbean. My parents came from Anguilla and Montserrat, countries that were part of the British Empire and which are still part of the Commonwealth. And they came here to what they were told was the mother country. And when they and that generation of people came, they came with the expectation that the mother country would embrace them with a warm, loving embrace. But of course we know the reality is that when those people came here, they were met with those signs saying no blacks, no dogs, no Irish. They were housed in the worst areas.
They were given the worst paid, least prestigious, most horrible, rotten jobs. Many of those people, of course, never intended to stay here for very long in the first place.
Let's make May the end of May. But let's also say this, because Kevin's absolutely right. All of a sudden, my parents and their generation and those Caribbean migrants from Windrush are popular migrants, aren't they? The papers, they all suddenly decide and have agreed that those people have made a contribution and should have a right to stay. Well, of course they should have a right to stay, and they have a right to demand the compensation that they deserve. But we should say also that every single migrant, every single worker who's come here from the European Union, who are now facing uncertainty about their future, they have a right to stay as well. And every single refugee who is coming here from war-torn countries, many of which have been devastated by the policies and the wars that have been promoted by governments such as ours, they have every right to be here as well. And we stand shoulder to shoulder with those people fleeing poverty and persecution and wars, whether it's economic migrants or not. They have a right to be here. We stand shoulder to shoulder with the people in those rotten camps in Calais, for example, who are trying to get over here. We stand shoulder to shoulder with people disgracefully in detention centres here in Britain who want the right to stay. We stand shoulder to shoulder with them, and we want to see the walls of those immigration centres coming down as well. We say everyone has a right to travel wherever they want to across the globe. It's ordinary working people who create all of the wealth in society, and it's the rich and powerful who steal that wealth off them and happily will invest the wealth that they make all over the world in the search of profits. We say that the people who create that wealth have the right to travel wherever they want to in the world in order to get their fair share of that wealth back. So yes, we've had a good day. We've had a good weekend. It's good that Amber Rutt is gone. But we say that May must go as well. And we say that every refugee, every foreign worker who lives and works here has a right to stay. And we're going to fight to defend their right to stay. Thank you, sisters and brothers. Let's keep the struggle going.
The Commonwealth.
And they passed a law then called the Aliens Act. Yep. It was meant to keep out people like my grandmother. Yep. Now, she was a difficult person, but you wouldn't pass a law against her. But when they passed that law, they put something in place that has been used in every single piece of legislation against migrants, refugees, Commonwealth citizens. It has been to divide people into desirables and undesirables.
Since then, I've been trying to get my passport back, re-stamped with my indefinite. But they've been lying to me, telling me that they have got no trace of me getting my stay. At the same time, they said that my file had been destroyed. I had my local MP, Mr. Keane, to write to them on my behalf. And the reply he had back from them was to say that my document had been destroyed. You know, I'm so hurt. I have got a close relative died in Jamaica, and I wasn't able to attend even the funeral. I'm so deeply hurt. I'm so glad for this opportunity. I know this would come to pass because I prayed, and I know that God would answer my prayer. When I listened to the Windrush situation, I know that God had been answering prayers. We are going to stand up for our rights. I came and I work. I've been in this country as a builder. I work so very hard, and I'm so deeply hurt to know that all my money been spent with to solicitor, and even the Home Office, they've been taking fees upon fees from thousands of pounds, and even people that they have turned down, they send them back to Jamaica without a penny. It is so unfair. It is so unfair. They knew that they would not have given them their stay. Why did they take the fee from them? This is so wrong.
So we're only talking about New Zealand, Canada.
Canada and Australia and wanted to completely forget about the rest. He made what this country truly what it is. This is a government that has spouted racism more than ever. It's a country where racism has blossomed, and at that front of that form of racism is Islamophobia, where Muslim people are too terrified to leave their house. Where is this government on a Punisher Muslim Day, where people were on the 4th of April, where people were terrified to leave their house because of attacks that was going to happen to them on the street, whether that be verbal or physical? I think our government constantly spouts racism and makes it a norm and makes it a part of our society.
Close down detention centers. Investitution. Justice for all those affected. So see you on the 31st of May. Come along, join in, let's keep this movement going.
That has been standing up for the Windrush people. Not now, not lately, but for the last 8 years. It was Dan Abbott that made the speech that said that in 2014 this was a wrong war. This was a wrong law. And I tell you this, when Diane stood up, she didn't stand with lots of people. There was a minority. And we should be proud that we have an MP that's prepared to tell the truth and speak the truth. Because when people don't have a voice, they get no justice. And I tell you that Diane has endured the worst levels of racism from any MP inside here. And it's about time that people connect the dots about hostile environment. Because we should support Diane Abbott and David Lammy and those people that speak up for us now. And I want to introduce Diane Abbott, MP for Hackney, the front bench spokesperson for the Home Office.
Of the Windrush generation is. This was a generation of people from the Caribbean who actually were proud to be British. This was a generation that believed in Britain. This was a generation that worked so hard and brought up their families. And the way that generation was treated was completely shameful. I will not stop until we get justice for the Windrush generation. But let's not forget, there are wider issues. There are other peoples suffering under our immigration system. So yes, we want justice for the Windrush generation.
The Commonwealth.
We also want justice for entire Commonwealth people. Because what is happening to Windrush generation will very soon happen to people from South Asia, people from West Africa. There's even been cases with Canadians. So we have to understand this is a wider issue. We have to campaign until we get justice, but we also have to campaign until we get a fair and equal and non-racist immigration system.
Why? This reason. One love, brothers and sisters.
To divide us, to separate us, and to break us down. And what we need to do is we need to do more than to stand up and to fight racism. We need to turn this hostile environment back on them. We need to be uniting for our trade unions. We need to be going out there on strike. We need to be standing up and protesting everywhere. We can't let this happen to us.
Thank you, Marvin. Thank you, Marvin. Our next speaker is Anthony.
Hello to you all. My name is Anthony Kreppel, and if any of you go on Twitter, you might have seen the face very, very often. I have two things to tell you. One, from the House, if you have not heard this. The new Secretary of State, who is the son of immigrants, he's in the mix. He will go, but not for that reason. He says this: I dislike the term hostile environment, and I suggest instead, and he immediately moved to using this, compliant environment. Letters to legals with no explanation and a threat of deportation is not compliance. Etymology, if you look in dictionaries, you look on the internet, compliant is not a synonym for hostile. In fact, it's what they call an antonym. It's the opposite. So you cannot substitute one for the other. Now I'm going to finish by reading you a limerick that I wrote in 1968, when I was younger than most of you are here, when I was 16. I wrote this in April 1968, and many of you might know what happened in April 1968. ML King, yes, he was black. A great man, so clearly on track. His words, loud and clear, were both champagne and beer. Please God, we so want him back. The champagne and beer reference, just for anybody who's not sure, means that he reached every person who heard what he had to say. The man stands head and shoulders above this one over here, who actually could have sold Generation down the river if he got enough money to do it. Thank you for listening.
Today we are here in solidarity with the Windrush generation. I want to say that the hostile environment, which is being said here, was first created in Africa because of the wars in Africa. Yes, by the Western government.
Ladies and gentlemen, speaking on behalf of the Muslim Association of Britain, I start with a verse from the Quran which stipulates a very important principle of the foundations of human relationships, and it addresses mankind, not only Muslims. O mankind, we have created you all for male and female, and made you in nations and tribes so you may recognize one another, not discriminate or exploit one another. The most noble of you in the sight of God is he who is the best in conduct, not race, language, status, or color. Feeling equal must be a conviction and not merely superficial political correctness. The Windrush case is merely symptomatic of a deeper and dangerous problem within certain sections of government and the British establishment. That is institutional racism. From that, far right and that racist group seek to legitimize their abhorrent rhetoric and extremist ideology, claiming, since the government is behaving in this way, why shouldn't we? Some might argue that racism is not as apparent as in other countries, but we should not be thankful for that, for it still exists. We see the lucky few who made it to important positions and we feel better. But we have to realize that there are hundreds who struggle with racism every day of their lives. It is essential that racist tendencies of all kinds are eradicated from all sections of government and of society. Otherwise, our societies, our social security as British people will be at risk.
Women in the United States of America, don't blame Wall Street, don't blame JP Morgan, blame the Muslims, blame the black people, blame the women for being too uppity. Those are the backward reactionary ideas that are now gaining currency not because people are just like that, but rather because of the ideas that come from the top, that encourage those ideas of division and making them respectable again. And so it's the same in Europe, where for the first time in a long time, we have a party elected in Hungary, but it's led by anti-Semites that have got elected on the back of Islamophobia and anti-Semitism. That's what their anti-Soros campaign was all about, with language that came straight out of Mein Kampf. And we've heard nothing from the Tory government condemning any of that. On the contrary, they've actually sent him congratulations to Orban, the new Prime Minister of Hungary. So just to finish, someone else said, but actually we need to step up the fight. It's good, but it's 50 years after May 1968 in France.
Tories out! Tories out! Tories out!